Welcome to We the People. This past week, a very, very public disagreement between two cabinet ministers, Prakash Javadekar and Maneka Gandhi, grabbed the headlines. The focus on television discussions tended to be on the politics underlying this disagreement. Was this in some way connected to Uttar Pradesh 2017? Was one of the questions asked. But the subject that's really at the heart of the disagreement was perhaps left ignored. When humans and animals come into conflict, is the answer really mass killing of animals? That's the question that has divided public opinion, with animal rights activists up in arms. In fact, the minister herself, Maneka Gandhi, used an extraordinarily strong phrase to describe the policy of the environment minister and his ministry. She called it a lust for killing, talking about how the ministry was in fact not just clearing but in fact encouraging states to kill animals. On the program today, we ask whether this is in fact a lust for killing or is it a reality check with no other options. Let me start with you, Gauri Moliki, if I may, because you are, of course, an animal rights activist, but you are also an advisor to the minister, Maneka Gandhi. Therefore, what you say in some ways also, I think, represents what she thinks. And not that she's been coy about what she thinks. When you use a phrase like lust for killing about a cabinet colleague, it's a very strong phrase. Is it one that people like yourself stand by?
The pattern that we have seen, it started in 2014 when the Ministry of Environment and Forest proactively wrote to the states asking which animals are kind of causing damage or whatever, and without asking for mitigation steps to be taken, invited applications, proposals under Section 62 of the Wildlife Protection
Act. So you're saying that the ministry I actually have the letter in front of me, in this 24th December 2014, on its own, writes to all the states.
That's right.
And therefore, you're saying this is suo motu.
This is unprecedented. Section 62 has always existed since 1972. But it was never used because there is an alternative present. There's Section 11 of the Wildlife Protection Act that empowers the chief wildlife wardens of each state to lay down a procedure, identify the animal, and in a very accountable manner destroy that animal.
So what is this advisory
this
say
is
to you? I have
arbitrary.
It in front of me. The advisory, to be fair to the ministry, actually says that this is because a number of members of parliament have approached us repeatedly.
They've
asked us for answers. So we're writing to the states.
The answers should have been to have experts. See, one thing we have to understand, in India there is no concept of wildlife management. Here we needed to import that knowledge, build that capacity, correct the steps that we had already taken to damage the
habitat. So in this
habitat,
advisory of December 2014, you are seeing an unusually proactive intervention by the centre, unprecedented. Now,
yes.
Sambit Patra, for once, this is not the opposition. This is an advisor to a cabinet colleague of Mr. Javadekar, right? So for once, actually, your friend Pawan and you are on the same side of this debate, because Bihar government and the central government are on the same side. Maneka Gandhi and animal rights activists are saying, why this advisory? Why this extraordinary intervention by the centre when wildlife wardens in these states can make this assessment on their own?
I broadly categorize this whole debate into two categories. One is the legalities, and the second aspect is the human aspect, whether culling should be a method or it should not be a method. As far as whether culling should be a method or not, we have experts over here. Even I would join that debate later. But initially, since I've been drawn into legalities, let me answer very legally. Since there is a Section 62 in the Wildlife Protection Act 1972, and for the benefit of the audience, I believe we should read that section out. The section states, I quote, "The central government may declare any wild animal other than those specified in Schedule 1 and Part 2 of Schedule 2 or H to be vermin for any area and for such period as may be specified therein."
So you can change the notification. You're absolutely right. That provision exists in law.
The first part is, the central government will act only when the state governments propose, approach the central government saying that, hey, there is a problem and you have to address this problem. The wild boars and the blue bulls, they're attacking us. Something has to be done. If an advisory is issued according to this law, I don't think anything illegal has been conducted by the central government. Now it is for the state government to act upon the advisory as they deem best. I stand here to be corrected if I'm wrong. Culling I think is the last option of adoption. It may be sterilization, it may be relocation, it might be tranquilization.
Okay, but I'm already seeing hands go up. Let me bring in Pawan. Let's just first get the politicians in. This is the rare agreement between you and Sambit Patra. I don't remember the last time this happened on a television program. But, you know, it could be argued from those of us who love animals. It really, really should be the last resort. And what animal rights activists are saying is that there are other methods. So one isn't saying that farmers do not have genuine grievances, but nobody talks about the root of it. If you are seeing this conflict, is it because we humans have in fact encroached areas that were once meant for wildlife habitation? Mm-hmm. Where are those debates?
Absolutely.
I think Barkha, it's not only me and Sanvit who are in agreement. I'm in agreement with you, but I put it to you also that it's an exceptionally unfortunate dilemma for those who have to exercise executive policy.
Okay.
Now take Bihar.
Yeah.
I say this because I'm an animal lover.
Yeah.
Take the state of Bihar in the Ganga and Gandak basin.
Yeah. You know,
there are an entire swath from Bhojpur to Bhagalpur,
yeah,
which have a surfeit of the Nilgai. Now the Nilgai mates twice a year, the numbers have increased exponentially.
Yeah.
The loss to crops from the Nilgais ranges up to 50%. Now I am all for not doing culling, but I have to somewhere also think
about
what do I do about farmers. These are small farmers on small landowners.
In fact, we have two farmers here and we hear from them.
Because that's the key to the debate.
Okay.
Now if another solution has to be found, where are the coordinates for a more human and sustainable
So first let me just bring Gauri in on this point that Sambit raised, that what is it that the ministry has done that is illegal?
No, it's not illegal. Technically,
yes,
but it's without application of mind.
But you have called it, not you.
62
says, one minute. But Miss Maneka Gandhi has called it a lust for killing by the ministry. You know, she said, "Ye kya havas lagi hai." That's the word she used.
If you see section schedule 5, Barkha, you'll see there's rat, mice, crow. I mean, species like that mentioned there.
Yeah.
You cannot put blue bull, the largest Asian antelope, into the same category as you put mice. We perused through the ministry files, the proposals that have been received by the ministry from 5 states. They do not substantiate or justify what the states have done to mitigate the conflict without having to come to the
last and then have to open it up. Yeah.
We need to find a more human and sustainable policy.
You agree with
I
that?
I agree with
you,
that.
You are saying you would rather not cull the Nilgai as 200
yes,
of them has been.
We can find solutions, but I want to add quickly. I say, who has taken the initiative to find this policy? And I ask this question to both previous government and this government. The National Board for Wildlife has not met for 2 years.
Exactly.
Who is applying their mind to this?
That's the apex body.
We've got Praveen Bhargav, a former member of the National Wildlife Board, coming in. But you want to come in?
Yes. Mr. Pawan Verma and the Bihar government, in fact, have been questioning the Bharatiya Janata Party government on the federal front. Here is a government which, upon your chief secretary, secretary Environment Vivek Singh writing to us, we have allowed them to take steps as per their wish.
As per the law.
In the sense, I have already mentioned that translocation first, sterilization, then culling is the last option.
Bihar chose culling as the first option.
Pavan,
I have to move on, so make your point quickly. Make your point.
We gave them the option as per the law and it was endorsed by the Environment Ministry, which is culling.
We're all speaking together.
The advisory has, however, killing of such animals can be restored to only when such animals cannot be captured.
Everybody hang on. Since everybody's talking about this advisory, it's right in front of me. The advisory actually says the issue of human wildlife is being raised at various fora and many honourable members of Parliament have raised these concerns in Parliament. The ministry has also received representations to take steps towards this mitigation of this conflict. So he frames
That's
it
right.
right. So he says this is what I've received. I'm responding to this. Now, interestingly, this advisory actually quotes from the TSR Subramaniam Committee and a technical analysis by the Wildlife Institute,
That's
saying
right.
that there is also one theory that says no purpose will be solved by this step. And when it talks about Subramaniam Committee and animals under Schedule 1, it says killing of animals can be resorted to only when such animals cannot be captured,
yes,
tranquilized, or translocated. Praveen, go ahead, and then Ambika. Yes.
Now she has raised a point with respect to the law.
Yes.
62 is the wrong application of the law. See, in law there is an established concept, which is you have to harmoniously read the law.
Yeah.
And if you read that law, 62, which does give, as Sambit Patra said, the power to central government to classify an animal
to change the classification.
Yeah, but under 11(1)(b), the state chief wildlife warden has the power to act and intervene wherever the situation has gone beyond control.
Okay.
Now, what it does is as follows. If you immediately shift Nilgai to Schedule 5,
yeah,
and there are interstate issues, Nilgai moves, ranges
local
across
migrations,
state boundaries and district boundaries, you will have a very funny situation where in district Champaran or whatever, it is in Schedule 3 and there is a case registered by a range forest officer. In the neighboring district, it is vermin. And somebody says, I brought meat from Champaran.
So you're saying the law is too ambiguous. You're actually saying the law is too ambiguous.
The law has to be read in totality.
But that's a different debate.
No, but just one minute. Just one minute. 31 under the Wildlife Act says that nobody can enter a sanctuary with a weapon. You have agricultural enclaves within our sanctuaries. How are you going to control when somebody enters sanctuaries with a weapon? 39 says all wild animals will be government property. By moving it to vermin, it is going out of purview.
Property.
So the law has not been read
harmoniously
and in totality.
But at the moment, the law then seems to be a problem, leaving too many contradictions and ambiguities.
No,
there are ethical questions here. Mr. Panwar, he's the deputy mayor of Simla, where there's a huge debate on monkeys, right, which have also been reclassified recently after a request from Himachal Pradesh. So what do you do? Suppose somebody says to you, these are animals that are hurting human beings. They are destroying crops, they are biting people. Yeah. What do you do?
Barkha, there are many, many things that we consider harmful. But the answer is not a knee-jerk reaction to kill. Farmers are hurt by lack of irrigation. Are we shooting people who are use water? I mean, there are thousands of things that hurt one community versus another community. There are conflicts we see on a daily basis between states for water. But the answer is not to turn around and kill a community simply because they are voiceless, because they are not a vote bank. The environment ministry is supposed to be the protector of animals. It is not for the environment ministry to write to states saying, send us your animals who are a problem and we will give you an order to shoot them.
No, but they're saying that we're doing that. They're saying that the ministry says we're doing that after representations
let the agriculture minister write that letter. Why should the environment
minister be seeking permissions
to kill animals?
So you represent
Simla. It seems to be a completely misplaced letter to seek the destruction of animals.
I can understand the angst of Ambika and we all stand with Ambika. No, Ambika, really, from heart I say, thanks to you that at least there are people in this world who stand for animal rights. You all are animal lovers. No one wants to really cull them and kill them. But the issue
except
is
except the environment.
No,
ministry.
No. Please. You have to
she
understand.
Said except the environment.
I'll tell you why.
Yeah.
Look, if we would have not answered to the member of parliaments of Bihar, then the same, there would have been different lot of people saying that, look, here is a government which is so insensitive to farmers. Here is a government which is not
responding. I think
that's
a fair point. We have to
follow what Ambedkar has written.
I think the fair question from the BJP and the Pawan Verma. 1 minute. Is that what exactly are we accusing the ministry of if they are acting on the basis of petitions from MPs?
Absolutely. See, there are provisions that exist for many things.
Yeah.
There is a provision to use TADA. There's a provision to invoke the emergency. No. Just because such provisions
exist.
This is hyperbolic.
Mr. Parma, first give our Delhi audience a sense of the monkey issue in your state.
I don't agree with ma'am what she said. Actually, it is my municipal corporation has passed a unanimous resolution. The state governments led.
This is across party
lines.
BJP, Congress, and you're a communist.
Yeah, from the
CPM. So this is across party lines. I just want to make the point.
And I'll tell you why.
Yeah.
And when we have a Congress government. Previously, we had a BJP government. Unanimous resolutions have been passed by the state legislature. Even I am an animal lover, but what the animal lovers, so-called animal lovers do, when the state government intervenes and declares monkey as a vermin, then through n number of things, they approach the High Court and get it stayed.
You said, what are we discussing? Kill these monkeys? There's a Jaku temple there where you worship monkeys.
That's
why
right.
do you want to kill them? That's
an interesting thing.
You know, it's really, I'm trying to understand.
Before this, I was the state president of the Kisan Sabha. And this is what the argument was, that nobody is going to kill. Then, as a pilot form in Sirmaur district, that is one of the remotest districts of Himachal Pradesh, people gathered there, 500 people armed came. For the first time, they said, we have been able to sow maize in our, and we have been able to get that crop. Similarly, it happened in Una. where the blue bull was declared as a vermin. At
so is point. The issue so the crops point is, or is the issue
So the point is, it's not a permanent solution. We agree with that.
Okay.
The farmers are not to be blamed for this. This is a menace. Everyone agrees with that. But
nobody
this menace, how it is to be tackled, I think that is, and what they speak about wildlife board, tell me one single peasant organization leader which is represents the wildlife board. All big elite NGOs.
There
people,
is nothing
people
elite
who are
about NGOs,
so,
one.
You see, why?
And
why
secondly,
they are representing. They are representing. So the point is.
The people who defend
will,
animals
and,
defend
and
them
you
at
see,
their own
it's
cost.
It's 2,000 crores. That the annual loss that takes place in Himachal Pradesh.
So let me now let
and
me,
and Barka, last yeah. point that of the total 3,500 odd panchayats that we have in Himachal Pradesh,
yeah.
more than 2,300 are completely infested by monkeys and wildlife. What do you do?
So I think it's a fair question to say, what does the peasant do? Now I have sitting next to me, I have sitting next to me Nawab Shafat Ali Khan, who was identified as the killer family by Maneka Gandhi. She said you go around the country killing animals, and I want to just bring up those pictures. That's Nawab Shafat Ali Khan. By the way, this is not without license. Do not get confused. Tell us what's happening in these pictures.
I'm training the forest department of Bihar in this picture on tranquilizing. That's
okay.
A tranquilizing gun.
Yeah.
Dan inject. This is a man-eating leopard in Himachal which had killed 12 innocent children, and the forest department could not tackle it.
Huh.
This is a rogue elephant in Bihar which had killed 7 people and it had broken 25 houses. When the police couldn't shoot it, they could not tranquilize it. It had to be put down by
that?
A single bullet in the head painlessly.
And what's that?
This is wild boar shot in private lands in Maharashtra on a culling order.
Okay.
But now you see, this is a man-eating tiger. One minute, let me complete.
Yeah, let him complete. Let him complete. Let him complete. Let him speak. You can react after that. अरे उन्हें बोलने तो दीजिए. आपने कहा उनको बोलने तो दीजिए. बोलने तो. No, no, you are. No.
So he is going around the country killing animals. That's simple as that.
I will respond. I'm just letting him just.
As simple as that.
Yes. This is a tigress which came out of Pilibhit.
Yes.
Traveled 350 kilometers.
Miss Gandhi's constituency.
I don't have to name her.
Yeah.
Killed a dozen people.
Yeah.
3.5 months. Achha. It terrorized 19 villages. Yeah. Finally, when it became a man-eater, it was declared a man-eater. I was invited by the government of Uttar Pradesh to come and offer my expertise.
Yeah.
So you are an advisor to 5 state governments, and
that's
you have literally a license to kill.
Kill. That's right. Yes,
not
killer.
A license to kill.
Come to my state,
people will collect money to buy
that's
cartridges. The menace is so huge, I'm telling you. Over a dozen people have died in Himachal.
Now let's
get reaction. Come on.
Prerna, go ahead.
Just
yeah.
the killer.
And then
I'd first like to answer Mr. Patra.
No.
No, we have to go back because you said MP, MLAs have been petitioning. They've been petitioning for years. It's the first time, unprecedented, yes. that
the
minister. It has been as intensive. It's the first time. It's unprecedented that the ministry has proactively taken this decision.
Yeah.
Second, why are we only looking at culling? Why is it happening? Why are man-eaters going? Why do we have man-eaters? Why do we have that elephant? Because of deforestation.
Of course.
We are losing about 150 hectares of forest every day.
We have 17%
Let us finish. I forget. Diya Mishra also.
2% for the peasants.
Yes.
Can you just finish? You must
let
us speak. Why aren't we also addressing those issues?
That's
all I'm saying.
Okay.
Why aren't we addressing those?
Now, one minute. I want to bring up Diya Mirza, and then we can go back to the pictures we saw of Shafat Ali Khan's role. Diya, you're a very, very outspoken advocate, one of the rare people in the industry, talking about animal rights, wildlife rights. How do you see this entire debate?
I've been listening in very keenly, and I think that what is very, very apparent is a deep conflict of conscience. And I think that this mandate will only give rise to that. When we say we can cull our national heritage animal, the elephant in Bengal, we can cull or get rid of the national bird, the peacock, I'm concerned about what this precedent is going to do to the minds and the hearts of our children. Yeah. How are they going to distinguish the difference between these animals that they need to feel pride for, that they need to feel a sense of ownership and a sense of belonging towards, and the need to protect and conserve if we allow them to be killed. It's very apparent that culling is not the answer. I feel that this debate will compel the government And I hope that it also compels people who work in conservation to work with the government to come up with sustainable solutions.
Diya, one of the questions that came up here from Pavan Verma was that yes, we all agree that long term you need different solutions. What's the short term solution?
Well, I hope that there can be a more empathetic approach to a short-term solution. There is translocation. But of course, it is not as swift as shooting a gun at an animal and getting rid of it. It will take time, it will take energy, and it will take a lot of work on the part of not just the center, but also the state ministry to work with the wildlife bodies and get this done.
Okay.
The most important thing that I want to highlight, Barkha, is that man-animal conflict in our country will continue to be on the rise. Simply because we will all accept that there has been development that has been haphazard. Our corridors, our natural corridors are becoming blocked. And the more and that will give rise to man-animal conflict, it will only increase. What we need to do is to find sustainable solutions to rehabilitate these people, give them sustainable livelihoods, and maybe that is the only way we will have a shot to genuine conservation in the long term.
So,
otherwise, this problem will keep arising, and we will keep wondering as human beings what is more fair.
Okay, Mr. Sridharan, quickly, you've been a conservator. Pavan, half a second. Yes, Mr. Sridharan.
It seems that everybody thinks killing is bad and animal must be conserved. But think of the plight of farmers who are day in and day out are not able to do anything. They are under serious problems. The city people can easily say conserve city air. You cannot go to any village and you can't face even people. I have done tranquilization. I have done translocation 28 years back. I have done all means possible to protect the wildlife. Nothing is effective.
Diya, quick comment. Diya, quick comment. Do something
comments.
Barkha, it's unfortunate that we believe that the life of the farmer is not important just because we are speaking up about the life of the animals.
I think that's a fair point. I think that's a fair point. Why are we positioning this as an either or debate?
The value of life between humans and animals. We are meant to coexist in harmony.
I think we should all pursue the concept of harmony. But I do want to make
But those photographs you saw of the Nawab. Now, is he a hero or is he a villain? Maneka Gandhi says, ye to killer hai. Aur unke saath jo baithe hai, ye says that people will buy cartridges and give them to him.
I say to you that if it's a man-eating leopard who has become such because of the encroachment into the forest of habitation. We need long-term solutions, but you have to tackle this menace as well.
Let Pavan speak.
Diya is someone I respect. She made the point that what will our children learn?
Yes.
I want to say that's a valid point, but it's an equally valid point when a small holding farmer has his entire crop destroyed. What do their children eat? This is the point.
Animals do not come into crop areas simply because they want to destroy the crop. They come, monkeys for example in Himachal, they come with babies clinging to their stomach. They know they risk electrocution, poisoning, beating, all sorts of cruelty, but they still do it because they're desperate. They don't have a grain of food anywhere.
Pavan has one question for you. Pavan has a question for you.
They are not encroaching on
Pavan has a question for you.
Protected for the wildlife. 15% is for the peasant. Can you believe that? In Himachal, 17% of the area is protected for the wildlife. 15%
of the
peasants.
We have stolen
that.
What is your question, Pavan?
My question is that the cause of the problem has been long in building. And I want to say that all of us, cutting across party lines or positions, need to take responsibility for that. I want to say this act has been there since 1972 with the provision under Article 63.
But it's never been used.
Why have everybody not educated for its removal?
That's a fair point. That's a fair point. Okay, may I just request everybody? You have to let me call upon you to make a point because it's impossible to follow anything otherwise. I will first come to you. If it is human liability that has in many cases led to this conflict, then why should we make the animal answerable for human failure to create a sustainable model of development?
I understand that.
Right? 100%. What's the answer to that?
I have no answer for that. My point is, my point is, you see, I am a victim. I am a victim because of the colossal so-called development, because of large-scale dams that have come up in Himachal, because of deforestation, because of cement plants and all that stuff. This is a conflict that has really precipitated now. But the point is, we have 17% land still protected for the wildlife and just 15% for the peasants. And what sir was saying, my peasant is very marginal. And this has been tried and tested over the years.
Yeah.
Why don't you give the example of Australia, where they cull 16,000 kangaroos? Just
why should we?
That experiment was revisited. Mr. Pawar, move on.
Just a second.
Yes.
See, I would sincerely request to all of us that we should not cull each other's ideas. this is beautiful democracy. We were discussing something very serious. When there is a conflict between animal and human, the humans have to be more understanding. I do not want the animals who should be put behind the bars and who should be. But you're not following that. Madam, let me complete.
Okay, go on.
There is a political aspect over here. Yes, rightly put by
Pawar.
Madam, can BJP be given some undisrupted time, for God's sake?
What's your specific question, Sambit?
Question is, well, we have an aspect where the humans have to think about the animals. Then we have a political side as well. It's a long-pending problem. We have to sit down.
So can we now look at
options? We just cannot point fingers saying that this ministry went wrong.
Can we move this debate on to what should be done instead?
Baraka, you never allow the BJP to complete in a sentence. No, no, no. I accuse you of that.
Conspiracy.
I even accuse you of that. You don't allow BJP to make two sentences. Yes, on air, I accuse you. No, no, no. Very disciplinedly, I have been hearing, but you never allow the Bharatiya Janata Party to make three sentences incomplete.
Actually, the person who's arguing with you is an advisor to your party members.
I respect the NDTV does not allow Bharatiya Janata Party to complete three sentences. You can continue with the debate, no issues. We all are aware of what is happening.
Okay, let's just move on.
No.
You have an agenda, ma'am. Don't you read that?
Let's just move on. It's a discussion.
Excuse me. I object to that. If you want to convert this debate into NDTV's ideology, actually, first you have to debate her. She's an advisor to a minister in your government.
Madam,
how is this BJP and NDTV?
Madam, I am ready to debate to any extent if you allow me to speak.
So why would I not allow you?
You are not allowing me to come.
I have interjected you just as much. No, why don't you make your point?
Go ahead.
Why don't you complete your
point? How do I complete a point if I am not even given a hearing for 10 seconds?
When you're done with your conspiracy theory, you can come back to your point.
Okay, Gauri, why don't you answer?
No, let him make his point, because now that the conspiracy theory 5 minutes have been spent on it, now can we come back to the point?
Since Bharatiya Janata Party has been drawn into the fore, saying that two ministries fought. Yes. I say that this is not an issue of what ministries fought or not. It's a bigger issue. Yes, the bigger issue, this animal should be protected. Yes. Farmers' right have to be reserved.
Right.
The central government, a particular ministry that has been referred over here, that is the environment ministry, all that it did was as per the law laid by Mr. Ambedkar. So if the constitution is highest, we have followed whatever it was.
Now can we go move to what the options are?
Oh, yes.
Can we be productive? This is the thing. Because none of you can say that I'm picking on a political party because you don't represent them. I'm trying to interrupt everybody here because we need to streamline this conversation.
Yeah.
What should we do instead of culling? Can we focus on that? Praveen, I will start with you.
First and foremost is those images of people shooting. See, it affects sensibilities of people. That should stop. This whole business of employing shikar, if there is a true problem with farmers and people, that also needs to be addressed.
Okay.
But not in the manner and form that is being done now.
Okay.
It should be done properly and there should be safeguards.
Okay.
The problem with the order notification issued by Environment Ministry is there are no safeguards. For example, there is no time period specified. You shoot with searchlights. You see just two eyes burning. It could be a sambar, it could be a nilgai, it could be anything. And people going like cowboys and shooting, all this must
stop. That is wrong.
Yeah. The forest department must stop.
I think we can all agree on that. Yeah.
That's the immediate. The long-term solution is, we are massacring our forest areas in a very unscientific manner. 30 years of the best science is telling us that it is not loss of forest, but fragmentation of forests into bits and pieces.
Mr.
Now that is affecting. That has to be.
Mr.
Let me make one issue here.
You see, please understand, in Tamil Nadu, every week one person is getting killed by an elephant. His crop
so
is completely damaged.
In the, but in
no,
the
you
city,
cannot
city,
proactively control these animals
city,
and allow human beings to be killed. You
no.
please show some rights to us.
Okay. I will give everybody a chance. Hang on.
Coming back to the notification and adding to the few shortcomings there.
Yeah.
The notification does not say that address the other issues first. Why, if there is a conflict, then go into the reasons of why the conflict is.
Ask the states for feedback.
The Bihar government has given a 3-page proposal.
Yes.
It has not said that we have removed mining till the Nilgai is out.
Yes.
It has not said that we have removed encroachment and protected the habitat till the Nilgai is not being contained in the forest.
So
let me
just
finish. You cannot protect an animal without protecting its habitat.
As far as habitat is concerned, I don't believe 1.5 years or 2 years of government is
one
which makes the habitat.
Oh, okay, let me come.
As far as you saying that there were no options in the letter that was sent by the central government, as I read out previously, let me just tell. However, killing of such animals can be resorted to only when such animals cannot be captured, tranquilized.
But then why was it cleared up?
Why was it not cleared up?
And here is a notification.
Notification does not say go and kill.
Notification.
Madam, can I complete? I was listening to notification. Notification only shifts it from one schedule. These are the options.
There are others.
But when they answer her, it was all Gauri speaking all the while.
Samit, your answer is that the notification. Your answer is that the notification does say it should be the last resort, but you accuse the Bihar government of choosing Culling.
One of that.
Okay. Now, one request. If this side is finished, I'm moving that side of the room. I'm just going to take some questions along the way.
Can we all please talk about ourselves? Will humans kindly stop reproducing at such numbers instead of talking about animals reproducing? Can we have human birth control here?
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, you were having a very angry intervention, I think, on behalf of the farmers, right?
Yes. I think it's very easy for us, all of us, to just sit here and, you know, brag about our comments here and there. I agree with Ms. Ambika there that they should not be going inside the forest. But are you ready to chalk out a land of from your own farm and give it to the guy? And also one more point, ma'am. Let me complete. Everybody has talked. I have to agree with the deputy mayor of Simla here. There are a few farmers sitting here. जिसकी जमीन के ऊपर से ये एक बार निकल जाती है नीलगाय, आप उससे पूछिए, ask him.
जिनके फॉरेस्ट चले गए हैं उनका क्या एनिमल्स लैंड?
ओके, नाउ
द लैंड केम फ्रॉम वेयर?
लेट्स टेक इट बैक टू समथिंग प्रोडक्टिव. आई थिंक इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट केम फ्रॉम द लेडी हियर दैट वी वुड नेवर से दैट देयर आरंट एनफ रिसोर्सेज टू गो अराउंड फॉर ह्यूमंस. सो लेट्स यू नो इवन have a forced birth control campaign, Pavan. No state would do that, right? I mean, Sanjay,
vote banks.
Animals are not vote banks.
I don't want to sound cynical here, but if animals were vote banks, we would have very different positions on policy.
Absolutely.
Some little dig that you made did not escape me. But the heart of that point is a valid one, and I want to put it to both the politicians. That is it because animals don't have a voice in the political system that they matter so little? Yes. Pavan, you want to take that?
Yes.
I'm hearing yes from the audience, absolutely. But yes.
I think we must have a sane debate.
Yes, oh God.
And for those who are advocating that animals must have exactly the same right as humans,
no.
I appreciate their sentiment.
But
this is not fair. When you speak, nobody interrupts. You are always interrupting when other people are speaking.
Yes, I agree.
I'm sorry. I say to you, I have a farm.
Ji.
Very close on the border of Delhi. Till a few years ago, hordes of Nilgais used to come there.
Yes.
They have stopped coming. People have built Gurugram, which is the Millennium City, where a lot of people who are great activists of NGO movements live.
Yeah.
Did they stop it then? The point is this, that when it's somebody else's farm, somebody else's livelihood, it's easy to pontificate.
Okay, so let somebody take that. Prerna, and then Shafat Ali Khan have been waiting to speak.
Yes. 1 minute. Yes. What we are doing by killing bluebulls and Nilgai and wild pig is we are escalating conflict. Good. In the last 3-4 months, we have killed 300 wild pig in Maharashtra, in an area which is a high tiger density area, and therefore a high conflict area. We're killing off their prey base. So we are escalating conflict, and that affects the farmer even more, because we are killing his livestock.
Okay.
We need a more
I'll get a last comment from Dia. The fact that this can get so heated actually speaks to the fact that there hasn't been enough debate on our policy.
Yeah,
you know, that's what it represents to me. That we need a bigger debate. Ambika, Dia, go ahead.
This debate is a reflection of the fact that unfortunately an ecological balance has been deeply neglected in our country. When I hear people speak, it comes across as they consider themselves separate from nature, that they consider themselves apart from nature. We are as dependent on that ecological balance as a grasshopper or the Nilgai or the tiger. There is no immediate solution. If a practice has been adopted, what will really benefit the people of the country, especially the children, is if the government is using terms like scientific methods, then please make that scientific approach available to the people of this country. And I think for people who work in conservation on the ground, who are struggling to help farmers, agriculturalists, people who are encroaching on our natural habitat, to understand that they are invading into the space that has been protected to conserve nature. What you're doing is, by giving allowance for things like culling, you are deepening their resentment and hate towards the environment and nature.
I think there's agreement on one thing, despite the tempers that have flown in this debate, that long term you need a different model, you need a different policy. But short term, we've not been able to answer. Can I just hear? We've heard from very angry activists. आप किसान हैं, यहाँ आपके बारे में बात हो रही है कि नीलगाय से जैसे खेत को नुकसान पड़ता है, लेकिन लोग ये भी कह रहे हैं कि इसमें जानवर की क्या गलती, उस बेचारे जानवर की क्या गलती. दूसरा, हमने ये भी देखा है कि किसान स्वयं नीलगाय को मारने के लिए तैयार नहीं है, बाहर से लोगों को बुलाना पड़ता है. इसका मतलब थोड़ा किसान के मन में भी ठीक नहीं लगता, नहीं तो बाहर वाले जैसे शफत अली खान साहब बैठे हैं, उनको क्यों बुलाया जाता है? तो आप इसमें क्या बोलना चाहेंगे?
ऐसा है, किसान की हालत बहुत खराब है इस पशु की वजह से. अगर किसान का सबसे बड़ा शत्रु कोई है पशु जाति में, तो इस वन रोज है इसका नाम, नीलगाय नहीं है, ये नीलगाय है नहीं. नीलगाय कह के ऐसे लोग भ्रमित करते हैं धर्म की तरफ को, जबकि ये किसान का सबसे बड़ा शत्रु है.
और ये क्यों है कि किसान इसको खुद या लोकल लोग इसको खुद मारने के लिए तैयार नहीं है?
नहीं, किसान इसे मारता है, खुद मारता है. कौन कौन कहता है कौन नहीं मारता? किसान जिस किसान की फसल को ये बर्बाद कर देती है, किसान इसका वध करता है, हत्या नहीं करता है इसकी. हत्या वो होती है या शिकार वो होता है जिसे किसान करे और उसका मीट खाए, लेकिन किसान इसका वध करता है जो भगवान राम ने रावण का वध किया था. ये वध है, और ये गाय नहीं है. कोई भी कोई पशु प्रेमी इसे, कोई भी पशु प्रेमी ऐसा नहीं है. ऐसा मेरी बात सुनी जाए, ऐसी बात नहीं है कि मैं पशु प्रेमी नहीं हूँ. किसान से बड़ा पशु प्रेमी कोई पूरी दुनिया में नहीं है. किसान से बड़ा पशु
को ये नहीं लगता कि कोई और सोल्यूशन होना चाहिए, जैसे कि नीलगाय को कहीं और ले जाया जाए या उसका नंबर किसी और तरीके से मारना तो नहीं चाहिए.
वो जगह बताई जाए जहाँ पे किसान नहीं है, इसे वहीं पे ले जाए.
ओके, वो जगह बताई जाए. ओके, नाउ एज अनपैलेटेबल एज दिस आर्ग्यूमेंट मे सीम to many people here, we have to hear him, because this is definitely what we have to be able to address directly. Now, Gauri, you had a question for Shafat Ali Khan.
That's right.
Who we have seen is called in, whose family is called in, given a license and asked to kill either man-eating, life-threatening animals,
rogue
or
elephants.
Or culling.
We are rogues.
Few years
don't
back, an elephant in Haridwar went rogue, killed seven people.
Rogue elephant is inappropriate. He shouldn't use the term rogue.
Okay, you use the phrase rogue elephant. Rogue. Okay, 1 minute. Praveen just said, do not use the word rogue elephant. We, the humans, are the rogues. Don't judge the animal. Do you take back that phrase?
No, it's wrong. Anyway, in my shooting order, it's mentioned rogue elephant by the government.
Irrelevant.
So let the government correct it. It's not for me.
Okay. All right. So what happened was,
okay, now if you give me 2 minutes, I have a solution.
Yes. Mr. Khan,
if I
may have your attention. She has a question for you, please. And then we'll move
just
on.
A few years back, in Haridwar, an elephant, an angry elephant, killed about 7 people because its corridor was obstructed. Now, this Mr. Khan was in Uttarakhand begging the Uttarakhand government to allow him to kill the elephant.
No,
it did not happen.
I have never begged anybody.
The elephant was successfully
So that is a relevant question.
I am not saying you should not answer it. I am not saying you should not answer it. But equally, he is a consultant. Ambika, five state governments have used his
services. Never mind, he's still a criminal background.
You are being accused of criminal antecedents. Would you like to respond?
Have you ever been arrested?
Now let's listen to him. You've asked him a question. Let him please answer without shouting him down. Yes.
There's no criminal case pending against me.
Have you been arrested?
No. Court has convicted me in my lifetime.
Was your accused?
That's
were
not
you,
the way
was
how
accomplice?
This debate has to go.
Every politician is accused of something or the
your
other.
Was
there's no saint without a past.
Okay, so he said that he faced charges in the past. He was not convicted. He answered your question. Yes. Now let's move on. What are your solutions?
One second. Yes. Now listen, lot of water has flown. And lot of research has done on alternative measurements. What are the alternative measurements? Nothing is coming out of this house. Bihar government has done a research on solar fencing. It does not work. Blue will jump over it. Then they have tried chain link fencing. Now when it comes to immune contraceptive vaccine, there is a drug called Conacone used in America for deer. But Nilgai is not a deer, it's an antelope. When horns branch, they are called deer.
Yes, yes.
When horns don't branch, they are called antelope. Yes. So blue bull is an antelope.
Okay.
This drug Conacone has not been tried on any antelope successfully.
Okay.
Government of India has requested CCMB in Hyderabad to come out with a drug that can be used to retard the reproduction of blue bull, but till date there is nothing available. A blue bull consumes 21.5 kgs of fodder in one night. Its lifespan is 21
What's the
years.
Solution, sir? What is the solution you're proposing?
What is happening across the world. In Africa, which is a much larger country with much
it's
more
not a country,
game,
it's a continent.
They identify a block. And in this block, they say, all right, if there are 2,000 kudus, 30% in forest land and 70% in...
I will take a few audience questions, then you will all get your 30-40 seconds to make your concluding remarks. Okay?
I want to ask you, what have you done for the monkeys before calling them vermin? What have you done?
Short answer. Yes.
You know what we call is ABC, that's animal birth control. We cannot do beyond that. And this is what we have done, sterilization. But sterilization doesn't work. I am a victim because I am not the government. I am part of.
Okay, I am coming back here. Sir, in your concluding comment, you can.
12 people have died.
I just want to say that there has been, like you are saying, we have to follow what other countries, what other continents are doing. There is enough research to say Yellowstone National Park, there is enough research to say UK mein foxes, etc. Any species culling has not worked. What you're calling a long short-term solution has long-term repercussions that you're not talking about.
Question here.
When you kill animals, then tigers come in to eat children. Then you send a trigger-happy Nawab to kill the tiger and take photographs of himself. I don't think we're reaching anywhere. We need short-term solutions. Do we have one?
Mahatma Gandhi said that to judge the moral progress of a nation, it will be judged by the way the people treat its animals. And we are killing these Nilgai. If they were a vote bank, we wouldn't be killing them.
That's right.
This needs to stop.
There is something called crop compensation available that the government needs to, look into that rather than turning it into such a medieval practice.
Yes.
I mean, why are we resorting to the last resort? When we have something called a crop compensation, and when a 9-year-old in Kenya can come up with something called lion lights, why can't we use something like that?
Okay, now I'm going to start asking everybody for concluding remarks. Please keep your comments to 30 seconds if you can. Prerna, I'll start with you.
Yeah, so one, we need holistic solutions, not just one trigger happy solution. Two, such solutions in Africa have not worked. It has increased conflict.
I agree. Monkeys and other wild animals are not a problem. In fact, the problem is a manifestation of larger ecological.
Yes.
That's one. Now, this is what we have brought from the movement.
Solutions.
Yes, solutions. Short term and long term.
Yes.
Short term export, which is banned, yes, since 1978.
Okay.
Scientific culling. That's why I'm here. Crop insurance, what you were saying. And intervention under NREGA, because that is one important, okay, element that is. And
right,
long-term sterilization and habitat revival.
Okay.
I stand for that.
Quick.
Last, yeah.
All right, last call. Mr. Sridharan, and then Praveen. Mr. Sridharan.
Yeah. Yes. Here the situation has to be rational, it has to be practical, it has to be realistic. People are struggling and dying. If you don't do it, they'll retaliate. Wildlife conservation will not succeed. People's support is necessary. Farmers' support is necessary. It is waning, and all the action taken will only succeed if you compromise on certain principles. Definitely.
Okay.
So there is no matching up at all.
Praveen, please try
to understand.
Praveen.
Reduce the numbers.
No, I disagree. We don't have accurate data on population.
Exactly. Yes.
First and foremost, that must
no
be done. Second, this whole thing must be looked at holistically in terms of science. We are not using good science,
yes,
that is available. Unfortunately, committees and task forces only have Sarkari favorites.
Yeah. Yeah.
They get on to that, you don't get solution.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, Dr. Patra. This,
yeah,
is the reality.
Yeah.
And unless we do that, and the last point I need to make, let's put this in perspective. Yes, there is a real problem on the ground for farmers. We need to address that.
Yes.
But his point that people are dying, hundreds of people are dying, unfortunately, in road accidents.
But
have we stopped using roads?
Okay.
Just want to make briefly, for God's sake, the animals
this
that are slated to be killed, and I use the word killed purportedly, not culled, because it's just a euphemism for killing healthy animals.
Yeah.
These animals are known the world over as sentient animals because they have, like us, they are mammals. They suckle their young, they have a central nervous system, they have they have all the cognitive abilities that we have.
Yeah.
We cannot call them vermin, I'm sorry, that's absolutely
new. You want to
add to that? Yes. I won't go bigger picture. We talk about a lot here, a lot of pictures. What's happening in Himachal? It's not being controlled, it's not being controlled, it's not being controlled. Where is Hindustan? Hindustan mein ahimsa shuru hui thi, hum logo ne ahimsa shuru ki thi aur aaj hum hinsa ka sahara le rahe hain aur agar hum log yahan pe solutions nahi dhoond pa rahe hain samasyaon ka to ye kiski galti hai, murkh hum hain, janwar nahi, aap janwaron ko kyu dosh de rahe hain?
Ambika, last comments. Yes,
the blue bull is unique to India. Just as we have black buck sanctuaries, why don't we turn the blue bull into a national icon? It's unique to India. It's a beautiful animal. It's
but
a
what
shy,
what do we do with
timid
the ones destroying the farmers'
no,
crop?
No, why don't we create an area for them and
okay
feed them with all those crops that are being waste, all those grains that are being rotting in our
silos. Let me just put that
why
to
not
him
just allocate that grain to them, create a fenced area, keep blue bulls there and turn them into
wait,
a tourist revenue-generating resource.
It's a thought and I'll put it to Pavan in a second. Marne ke ilawa, janwar ko marne ke ilawa koi aur chaara nahi.
ऐसा है कि स्टेट वाइज जो है अपने अपने स्टेटों की अलग अलग समस्याएं हैं, कहीं पर नीलगाय का है, कहीं पर हाथियों का है, कहीं पर बंदर का है, तो ये जो है सारी चीजें स्टेट गवर्नमेंट के अंदर आती है, पर सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट जो है पूरी कंट्रोलिंग जो है,
तो उनको कोई पॉलिसी बनानी पड़ेगी. पवन, पवन,
आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू से वेरी ब्रीफली, ऑब्वियसली किलिंग एनिमल्स इज नॉट एन एक्सेप्टेबल और लॉन्ग टर्म सोल्यूशन. I think we have the country's most famous animal rights activist as a cabinet minister of this government,
yeah,
and you have a minister of environment. I think they should put their heads together and draw
yes
up a long-term policy,
yes,
which
yes
provides solutions.
Okay, so therefore I think that's the cue to put it to both
yeah
of you.
Yeah.
Gauri, and then Sambit can have the last word. Gauri.
Okay. मैं भी हिंदी में बात करूंगी इससे कि हमारे किसान
जी
भाई सुन पाए.
जी, जी.
आज की डेट में जो हमें फोन कॉल्स आ रहे हैं बिहार से, उसमें बताया जा रहा है कि ऐसी मार्मिक बता रहे हैं वो कि जो नीलगाय मारी गई उनमें से कुछ तो कोई प्रेग्नेंट थी, तो कोई बच्चा था, इतने छोटे छोटे नीलगायों के बच्चे भागते फिर रहे हैं, जो अनाथ हो गए हैं, अब उनको नहीं समझ में, वो भी कुछ दिन बाद मर जाएंगे, गोलियां किसी के पेट में लगी, किसी के पैर में लगी, कभी 12 घंटे बाद मरे, ये डेथ
सेंटेंस नहीं हमें सूट करेगा. अगर हम उनके घर को सुरक्षित कर दें तो वो भी सुरक्षित रहेंगे, लेकिन हम उनको घर ना छोड़ें और फिर कहें कि वो हमारे खेत में क्यों आ गए, तो ये तो कोई चारा नहीं है.
कोई और मारने का संदेश है कि आपको किसानों से भी कमी खराब हुए संदेश आए थे किसानों से भी.
किसान के बच्चे भूखे
मरे. एक मिनट, यहाँ पे बात ये हो रही है. एक मिनट, आई एम एट द एंड. यस, ये एक तरह से ये जानवर और किसान की लड़ाई नहीं है. इसमें हम सोच रहे हैं कि बेस्ट सोल्यूशन क्या है कि जानवर को मारने की जरूरत ना पड़े. कलिंग ना हो, मैस किलिंग. व्हाई आर वी यूजिंग दिस पोलाइट वर्ड कॉल्ड कलिंग? इट इज मैस किलिंग ऑफ एनिमल्स. आई थिंक इट्स जेनोसाइड, सेज गौरी. नाउ आई थिंक वन पॉइंट इज फेयर दैट दिस इज अ डिसोनेंस दैट इज कम अप ऑन पॉलिसी फ्रॉम विद इन द कैबिनेट. व्हाट इज द गवर्नमेंट सोल्यूशन और रिस्पॉन्स टू दिस कोहेसिवली? Very quick, I have to end now.
Three quick points.
Yes.
Number one,
yes.
As far as the government is concerned, the government has only discharged its federal responsibility on the call from the states by taking the stance of a law which has not been amended by this government, number one. Number two, Deepak Mishra, Supreme Court Justice, observes, I quote, there is a need to balance compassion for animals and existence of human beings. This is Supreme Court on this. And thirdly, a spiritual point, jo main Hindi mein kahunga, humme se jitne logon ne kaha hai ki jungle kat raha hai, bilkul sahi kaha hai, magar wo sab apne zindagi mein jhaanke ki unka ghar kitna bada hai, us ghar mein kitne bade bade antique lakdi ke furniture hai, kaun si gaadi wo chalate hain, kitna AC unke ghar mein hai, kaise kapde aur joote wo pehante hain, to wo jaan jayenge ki kitna jungle unke liye kata hai.
I will have to close. This will carry on endlessly. But I'm really sorry. I will have to close here.
My 30 seconds.
मेरा एक सुझाव है. बगैर हत्या करें मेरा एक सुझाव है.
I have to close here. I am closing here with just the conclusion that the fact that there is such a lot of volatility in this debate underlines the fact that policies have been carrying on. If they've been carrying on since the 1970s, they need re-examination in 2016, yeah. And they need to be treated with priority, and that much we can agree on, that just because these are not voting constituencies does not mean that nobody in parliament should stand up and speak for them or think about them. But we will close it there. I'm out of time. Thank you very much.